Hello, welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to talk about your auditing in a computer-based information system. Previously, we were able to talk about or tackle your transaction processing system, and we were able to introduce to you the different transaction cycles. You have your revenue cycle, expenditure cycle, and your conversion cycle. In this topic, we will now start how you audit those cycles involved in a computer-based information system. Now, the questions to be addressed or the topics that we will be discussing today will be about the scope and objective of your audit work and the major step that will be taken during the audit process in CIS environment. Next is the objectives of the information system audit and the four-step approach of meeting those objectives. You have your design study and evaluation of your internal control in an AIS environment. Next is the different computer software and how they are useful in your audit of an AIS. And of course, the nature and scope of your operational audit. Of course, I advise you to not forget our previous topics, okay? Originally, when you talk about your audit, you are more familiar on your manual audit, okay? Meaning you have your FS with you, you have your company, you have their journals, the different transactions, the different documents involved in the transaction, you have the ledgers, you do vouching manually, you do verifying, you do completeness test, okay? In the computer environment or audit in your CIS, ideally, the steps that you take or that you follow is the same. The difference is only one, okay? In the previous or in the traditional audit that you do it manually. The difference here is you do it in a computer. So you have to also identify not only the manual controls that they have, but also the controls that they adopt in the computer system, okay? So we are going to focus on the concept and techniques that we are using in an AIS audit. Now, the auditors are employed for a wide range of tasks and responsibilities when we talk about your AIS audit. Number one, they employ internal auditor to evaluate company operation. Initially, it's not only or it's not immediately about external auditors. It will be your internal auditors first who will help the company evaluate the company operation, specifically their controls, okay? Next one, the government employ auditors to evaluate as well the management performance and compliance with legislative intent. That's also true here in the Philippines. You have your COA, they do their government audits, okay? Next, you have your Defense Department employing auditors to review financial record of defense contractors. And of course, your publicly held corporation, this is the most famous audit process or audit services that your external auditors do. They provide independent review and opinion on the financial statements of the organization. So aside from providing opinion, before they do that, they audit or they test or they check the basis on how the company is creating their FS. And today we are engaging not only on the manual audit itself, but also on the computerized system. All right, so this chapter is written primarily from the perspective of internal auditor, but also for external auditor. So in terms of the external auditor, that will be injected later on. So they are directly responsible for helping management improve organizational efficiency and effectiveness. Again, who are they? It is your internal auditor. Your external auditor will now check the fairness of your financial statement. How do they check that? By checking your system, by checking if you complied with the different related standards in preparing your FS. As for the internal auditor, their role is to help organization check organizational efficiency and effectiveness. They also assist in designing and implementing the AIS audit. So your internal auditor will also help or can help actually in your AIS audit that will be conducted by your external auditor. Who are our external auditor? Can you give an example? You have your SGV, you have your KPMG, Ernst & Young, who else? You have your PwC, and the other Filipino audit firms that we have here in the Philippines. Okay? Those are your external auditor. Your internal auditor are employee of a company. Okay? That's why when you do your audit, the signed or the audited FS is not by the internal auditor. It is by your external auditor. All right? Now, the external auditor are primarily responsible to shareholders and investors because they are concerned with the AIS effectiveness. Okay? But it is indirect. Why? Because their main concern is the fairness, okay, of your financial statement. Your internal audit concept applying also on external audits. But why do we have external audits? Number one is for the independence of the audit, because if the audit itself, the FS audit, is done by your internal auditor, there will be bias. Okay, there is a possible bias. There is no independence at all because, of course, your internal auditor will report according to what is favorable to the interest of the organization. Now we go to the definition and the nature of your auditing. Actually, when you go to the definition of your audit, it is now providing to you the nature of the audit. Let us start with the first one. According to AAA or American Accounting Association, your audit is a systematic process of objectively obtaining and evaluating evidence. Let us further elaborate. Why did we say that it is a systematic process? Because number one, before you do your audit, you have a plan. And your plan is to be followed. That's why you have a systematic process. Next, objectively obtaining. Why is it objective? Because you have criteria. Okay? And your criteria, if you try to go over it, you have it on your auditing theory. Okay? That is why that's called an objective obtaining of your evidence. And when you do audit, how can you certify or ascertain that the FS is fairly stated, okay, without misstatements, by using your evidence. Next, it is a systematic process of objectively obtaining and evaluating evidence regarding assertions. What are the assertions? The assertions are the items presented on your FS. You are asserting that your cash is worth 100,000 pesos. That's one of your assertions, okay, about the economic actions and events. On your income statement, what's your assertion? You assert that your net income is, okay, is 1.2 million. That's part of your assertion. Is it correct? Is your assertion correct that your net income is 1.2? Your audit comes in, okay? Next, to ascertain the degree of correspondence between those assertions and the established criteria. So there should be correspondence, meaning agreement between your assertion and the criteria. What is your criteria? Your criteria are your PFRSS, your standards, your GAAP. So is it in accordance or is your assertion in accordance? Let us say your net income. When you recognize your revenue, is it in accordance with your revenue standards? So it should be ascertaining. So it should ascertain the degree of correspondence, meaning it should jive, it should be comparable, or it should be in accordance with your criteria. And lastly, and communicating the results to interested users. How do your auditors communicate your results? It is through their audit report. What's in the audit report? Their opinion. Okay? And if you go back to your auditing theory, you have four types of opinion. You have your qualified, adverse, disclaimer, and your unqualified. So what's the best opinion? The best opinion would be your unqualified, meaning your FS are fairly stated without any material misstatement, and it is reported according to the standards given by the Reporting Standards Council. Okay? So that's the nature of your audit. Now, your audit requires a step-by-step approach. So what is the step-by-step approach? It is according to the audit plan. Okay? It is according to what is planned. So you should carefully plan your audit. You should also use technique on how you will be doing the audit. Okay? Next, your audit involves collecting, reviewing, and documenting audit evidence. You should not be just saying that you have an evidence verbally. You have to document it. It's either a proof that this transaction happened. It could be a picture that a fraudulent transaction will happen. It could be a video that this employee is having or has an access on a certain computer system, which should not happen. So those are some of your evidence, okay? But most of the evidence are in documents. So you have your journals, the vouchers, the transaction receipts, or invoices. Next, your auditor uses criteria such as principles of management and of course the criteria provided by your Philippine auditing standards, okay? Of course, for other countries, they also have their own auditing standards depending if they adopted some auditing standards or if they have their own. Auditors used to audit around the computer and ignore the computer programs. That's the original nature of your audit. But today, in our topic, it's not ignoring the computer anymore. We have to inculcate or we have to now inject the idea that you have a computer system together with your financial reporting. So as you do your financial reports, how did you do that? You did that with the help of your computer programs or computer system. So you also have to audit. Is your computer system efficient? Is your computer system secured? So you have to audit that part, okay? Next, what's your current approach? Audit through the computer. So that is our current approach. Use the computer to check the adequacy of system controls, data, and output. What do you usually do or what do you usually audit in a CIS environment? Number one is the flow of the transaction. That's why we were able to talk about your transaction documentation during the previous video. Because in this topic, when you do your audit, you audit number one, the flow of the document or data. Where does it go? Who has the access? Number two, your control. That is the most important part in your audit in CIS. Okay? And it also determines, or your auditor also determines, and in order to determine, they should also have specialized skill because they have to determine how the audit will be affected by the IT of the computer system. They are going to assess and evaluate the IT controls. And of course, they will design and perform test of control and substantive test involving your computer system. So again, what's the difference here? The difference is that you have to include already the computer system in your traditional audit. Okay. So let's go to your internal audit standard. According to Institute of Internal Auditors, the purpose of internal audit is to evaluate adequacy and effectiveness of a company's internal control system. Again, that is for the internal auditor, but for the external auditor, it is on your assertions already. Okay? Another purpose of your internal audit is to determine the extent to which assigned responsibilities are carried out. So the external auditors, when they do the audit and there are questions, they can actually ask the internal auditor, why is it that this system is accessed by a certain department which should not be happening? So that can also be a question to be thrown by your internal to your internal audit, I should say, by the external auditors, okay? Today's organization uses computerized AIS to process, store, and control company information. That is why we now audit. Because what could happen if you do not audit your system? There could be fraudulent transaction happening in the system not seen by the user, only those who perpetrated the fraud. So if you try to notice as well, aside from your audit planning, audit documentation under your Philippine auditing standards, you also have procedure in identifying fraudulent transactions. Okay? Also, remember those items because you tackle those under your auditing theory. Nonetheless, let's continue. Okay? You do your computerized audit to achieve the five objectives. An internal auditor must be qualified to examine all the elements of computerized AIS and use the computer as a tool. This means that your internal auditor should be highly linked or should be highly working together with your IT department. Okay? Because it is your internal audit who should be stating that this department should only have lead-only access or this department may modify this report. That is coming from the internal auditor. Internal auditor should know more than any other departments on who and who should not be able to access a certain document, a certain system, okay? And your internal auditor should know more regarding your controls. Next, let's start with your five audit scope standards that will outline the internal auditor's responsibilities. Of course, aside from your external auditor, your internal auditor plays an important role in your AIS audit. Number one, they should review the reliability and integrity of operating and financial information and how it is identified, measured, classified, and reported. So before your external audit actually comes into the picture, your internal audit should have done this initially, so that if there are processes in the audit plan by the external auditors that needs to be done, pwedeng hindi na nila gagawin kasi bakit ginawa na ni internal auditor. And so, internal auditor can now help for the external audit process. Next, your internal auditor should determine if the system designed to comply with these policies, plans, procedures, laws, and regulation. So your internal auditor should know more better than the top management. So kahit top management pa yan, pero pag sinabi mong internal auditor, they should know better in terms of the control, the system, okay? Meaning, when you hire internal auditor, number one na gagawin ng internal auditor mo, internal auditor, is to check your system. He or she should be knowledgeable of the system para later on, ma-identify niya ito bang specific document na to when it flows into the system, ma-access ba siya ng Department B? Okay? Now, titignan niya, dapat bang ma-access ni Department B? Okay? Kung yes, okay lang. Kung hindi, lagyan natin ng control. Okay? Next, your internal auditor should review how assets are safeguarded and verify their existence. Even before the external auditor create a plan and do evidence collection on how your assets are safeguarded and how they can verify the existence of your asset, the internal auditor should have done this. Okay? Para yung external audit mo, parang double checking na lang yan, eh, di ba? Because their main purpose is to identify if your FS is correctly stated. Paano ba nila ma-identify kung correctly stated? Kung safeguarded ba yung asset mo? Kung nag-e-exist ba talaga yung asset mo? Also, the completeness of your liability. Internal auditor should also identify. Kasi syempre, sino ba namang company ang gustong mag-represent or mag-present, I should say, ng mataas na liability? Wala. So dapat sa external auditor ang gagawin niya to check the completeness. Ibig sabihin, dapat lahat ng liability mo, kaya maliit, kaya malaki, dapat naka-report. Yan yung sa external audit part. Now, anong role ni internal auditor? Ang assistance niya doon is to initially do that process already. Okay? Next, examine the company resources to determine how effectively and efficiently they are used. Let us say the materials. What else? The labor. What else? The system itself. Okay? Siguraduhin ni internal auditor na ang paggamit ng system only for legal purposes, only for correct purposes, and of course, nandiyan dapat yung authorization, authentication, segregation of duties, and the other controls that you have. Lastly, internal auditor should review company operation and program to determine if they are being carried out as planned and if they are meeting their objective. Again, anong role ni auditor? To help the management achieve organization's goal effectively and efficiently. So, dapat magawa niya talaga yung number 5. The auditor should know better ano ba yung takbo ng operation ni company. Okay? Para alam niya, baka kulang pa yung control natin dito or baka sobra naman o kaya naman baka no control at all itong certain department natin. So, he or she can implement certain controls later on. Next, we have your different types of internal audit work. Ang kadalasan naman na ginagawa ng external auditors, ganito din naman, okay? But in terms of independence, I should say, in terms of independence, ang highly independence kailangan natin dyan in terms of external audit, okay? Financial audit. But in terms of internal audit, of course, there's no independence at all, but they do these three types of audits. Number one, financial audit. You examine reliability and integrity of your financial records. When you say reliability, meaning it will be helpful to decision making. And integrity, it will secure or it will assure the trustworthiness, okay, of your information. Meaning the information should not be modified unless allowed or authorized. Next, they do information system audit. Ito yung kung bakit may AIS audit tayo ngayon. They review the control of an AIS environment to assess compliance with internal control and policies. Because if you have internal control in terms of your operation, dapat may control ka din in terms of your computerized processes. And of course, your operational audit that is concerned with economical or efficient use of the resources of the company to accomplish the established goals of your organization. All right. So let's have an overview of the audit process. Again, the audit process, this is in terms of your external auditors now. How do your auditors do the process? You just go back to your auditing, okay? Auditing theory. You have your plan. Of course, punta muna kayo sa engagement. But of course, after engagement, assuming okay na kayong dalawa, i-audit mo na si company A, okay? You start with your planning. Under your planning, dito mo ipa-plot lahat ng sequence ng gagawin mong process. Next, after planning or after polishing, what is to be done, you start collecting evidence. The evidence will be the item ascertaining your assertion into its correspondence with your criteria. Ano ulit yung criteria? Balikan mo yung auditing theory mo. You have a lot of criteria, di ba? Okay. So yung criteria na yan, dapat ma-meet yan ng evidence na mga kukunin mo to ascertain that your FS is fairly stated. Next, evaluating evidence. Okay? Later on, we'll have how you evaluate your evidence, specifically in a computerized system. And lastly, you communicate your reports through your audit report. Audit report, nandun yung mga findings as well as the auditor's opinion. Okay? Let us start with your planning. Kailan mo ba i-complete or i-conduct yung audit? Nakalagay yan dyan. Sino yung mga involved? Okay? And by whom will the audit be performed? Sino mag-audit? Si Ernst & Young ba? Si KPMG ba? At sino i-audit? Dapat naka-identify. Okay? What's the purpose of the audit? Is it an operational audit? Is it an FS audit? Is it a compliance audit? You have to specifically identify. And of course, you identify the scope and objective of your audit. Okay? The scope and objective of your audit should be stated in the audit plan para alam mo kung ano yung step na gagawin mo. Kasi yung objective mo and scope, yun yung basis ng mga specific procedures na gagawin mo. Again, your audit plan is not yet the procedure itself. Okay? So, pinaplano mo lang yung step by step na gagawin. Next, internal audit may be broader in scope, more detailed and extensive than external audit. They may also focus on company objective, not just whether the financial are stated properly. So, kung try mo tingnan yung mga ginagawa ni internal audit mo kanina na nilagay natin, actually, those are more detailed as to what your external auditors are doing. Si external auditors kasi, they are doing audit, number one, with randomness. Okay? They just try. If they do vouching for completeness or for verifiability, diba? I-check lang nila, is the transaction really existing? Or let us say for completeness, is this liability presented on your FS? Yun lang, diba? Parang yun lang yung goal nila. But the internal audit is everything. Okay? In your audit planning, you are expecting three types of risk. Okay? You are conducting an audit with these three types of risk that focus on different areas. Number one, inherent risk. When you say inherent risk, these are risks that are susceptible, risk that this is or the FS or the control is susceptible to material risk. Meaning, nandyan man or wala si entity or nandyan man or wala yung control mo na yan or meron at wala ka mang control, di ba? Basta there is the presence of the entity, there is that risk. Meaning, hindi mawawala yung risk na yan. Okay? Next, you have your control risk. The risk that the material misstatement will get through the internal control structure and to your FS and, ayan, and into your FS. Nasabi ko na pala. Okay? Meaning, whether there is a control implemented, number one, in your manual system and number two, in your computer system, there will and always be a risk. Yan yung control risk mo. Okay? Kahit na meron ka pang control structure, meron at meron ka pa rin risk. And lastly, detection risk. This is the risk that the auditor and their audit procedure will not detect the material error or misstatement. Meaning, kahit meron kang control or kahit nag-evidence collecting ka na or evidence collection, there is this risk na hindi mo madedetect na may error or misstatement on the financial statement. Okay, next. After the audit plan, you do now your collecting of evidence. How do you collect evidence? There are a lot of ways on how you do evidence collection. Number one, observation. Pagpasok pa lang ni auditor mo, nakita niya, ay, ang daming mga nakadisplay na files dito sa front desk. Hindi ba madaling makuha to ng kliyente at i-disclose nila sa labas? Okay? That's true observation only, di ba? Next, review of documentation. Dito papasok lahat ng transaction documents mo reviewed by your auditors to understand particular accounting information system and internal control supposed to that specific function or to that specific documentation. Next, discussion. Pwedeng interviewin mo si employee. Interviewin mo si management. O paano nyo ba ito ginagawa? O kaya si IT. O ito ba, sino bang merong access dito? O paano ba nagra-run tong computer system nyo? That's part of your discussion. Next, questionnaire. Pwedeng meron ka, literal questionnaire. Ipa-answer mo randomly sa kung sinong empleyado mo gustong ipasagot. And in audit, hindi mo i-announce kung kanino mo ipapasagot. Kasi syempre, pag i-announce mo kay company, op, ipapasagot ko to kay employee A, ha? Hindi mo sasabihin ganun. Kasi syempre, pag sinagutan ni employee A yan at nasabihan mo in advance si company, sasabihin ni company, oh, ito, isagot mo kapag tinanong niya to, ha? Wala nang independence or wala nang reliability dun sa information na ibibigay ni employee. Next, physical examination. Sabi mo, meron kang 1 million worth na PPE. Chinek ngayon ni auditor. Meron ba talaga? That's your physical examination. Another na papasok for physical examination is your inventory count and cash count. Okay? So, nag-inventaryo si auditor. Sabi mo, 560,000 ang value ng inventory mo. Eh, ang nandito lang naman sa warehouse mo, sabi mo, wala ka naman ng mga in transit. Eh, 550,000 lang naman. Okay? So, saan man naman gagaling yon nung nag-count siya ng inventory? Next, confirmation. Confirmation man gagaling to ngayon, most likely sa third party. Number one, kung may utang si company. Susulatan niya si creditor. This is to confirm is entity A has a debit, I mean has a credit or has a loan existing as of this point amounting to 250,000. Ngayon, i-assertify niyan or i-confirm yan ngayon ng creditor o kaya naman si customer. Sabihin ni customer, ay nako, wala po akong utang kay entity A, di ba? So si entity A, sabi niya may accounts receivable siya, yun pala wala naman. So ibig sabihin, mapaprove ni auditor na wala naman talaga. Hindi mo dapat i-record yung 10,000 na galing kay customer A. Ayan, so how do they do that? Confirmation. And yung confirmation, isa rin to sa mga random na ginagawa ng auditors natin. Okay? Next, reperformance. Sabi ni auditor, gusto kong ulitin ulit. Hindi ako na-satisfy. Diba? Sa accounting natin, pwede mong gawin reperformance as well as the process itself. Okay? Pwedeng reperformance of calculation, reperformance of the specific process, pwedeng reperformance of counting. Next, vouching. Ano ginagawa mo sa vouching? You are identifying the validity or certifying the validity of a transaction by examining all the supporting document. Okay? Okay, lahat ba tong sale na to, revenue sale from the sale of your inventory, lahat ba to existing or lahat ba to totoo? Saan man gagaling yung evidence niya na lahat yon totoo and existing? Okay? By doing the vouching. And you have your analytical review. You are reviewing the relationship and trends among information to detect items that should be further investigated. So, para kang nagsisensitivity analysis. You have your analytical review. After you collect evidence, you now evaluate audit evidence. Anong ine-evaluate mo sa audit evidence mo? You are evaluating materiality and reasonable assurance that are important when deciding how much audit work is necessary pa. So when you audit your evidence, sapat na ba to para masabi na tama ang balance ng cash niya? If not, there will be further audit work. If yes, okay na tayo. Okay? Next, in terms of materiality, yung judgment natin ng materiality, you should still remember that some material items or some items may be material in one entity that is immaterial to another. So you also have to consider the size of the entity, the size of the transaction as well. Okay? And the auditor will seek reasonable assurance that no material error exists. Again, laging material error ang ina-ascertain. Siyempre, kung immaterial, bakit mo papagtutuunan ng pansin? Of course, auditor will seek if there is no material error or misstatement in the information or process audited. Okay? And of course, reasonable assurance is not guaranteed. That's why you do your evaluation of your audit evidence. And of course, your communication, you are communicating your audit result through your audit report. Your audit report is a written report by the auditor reporting and summarizing the audit finding, the recommendation, and their opinion. So, huwag mong kakalimutan yung opinion niya kasi yung opinion niya, yun yung pinaka-importante. Okay? And of course, there will be post-audit procedure. There can be follow-up, diba? Alright. Now, you have your risk-based audit approach. In your risk-based audit approach, you determine threats. Are there possible fraud or errors that the system may face? Number two, you identify control procedure. Ano ibig sabihin ng control procedure? Ano yung process or control na ginagawa nila? Let us say, you have a single PC sa isang office. Sa office ba na yun, yung PC na yun, kung ano yung na-access ng isang employee, na-access ng isa? Diba? What's your control procedure most likely? Passwords, users, diba? Encryptions. Yan yung control procedure. Simple control procedure pa lang yun in terms of your system, computerized system. Next, in a risk-based audit approach, you should evaluate internal control procedure. Aside from identifying, you also evaluate. So how do you evaluate? You do system review and test of control to determine if those procedure can satisfactorily secure your information system, your computerized system. And of course, evaluate the weakness of your system and identify and check for compensating control. Anong compensating control? Kapag sinabing compensating control, kapag nakakita ka ng weakness sa system nila, you identify what possible steps you should take to lessen the weakness of the control. Meaning, to slowly strengthen the control. Kasi mahina eh, weak yung control mo eh. So how can you do? That's what you call your compensating control. Okay? Alright. So information system audit. For a system information audit, auditors have to make sure that the following 6 objectives are met. Okay? So, met or meet. Okay. Ano yung mga objective na yan? Security provision. That should ensure that the protection or that should ensure to protect computer equipment, your program, communication, and data from any unauthorized access, modification, and destruction. So your first objective is security provision. Second, program development and acquisition. They are performed in accordance with management's general and specific authorization. Next, program modification. It should be with management's authorization and approval because if the auditor found out na merong mga modification at hindi naman approved, kasi kadalasan dapat yung mga ganito, written yan. Okay? So, walang written approval of audit. Okay? Number four, processing of transactions, specifically your files, reports, and other computer records should be accurate and complete. Walang missing dapat. So, lahat ng dapat niyang sundan na process or procedure, lahat dapat yun masunod for the processing of transaction. Number five, you should also make sure that source data that are inaccurate or improperly authorized are identified. So, dapat kasama to dito. Magka, ano yung dalawang yan? Rubbing elbows. Your processing of the transaction and the source data. Okay? Because in order for you to identify the completeness and accuracy of the transaction, dapat meron kang source document. And of course, you test your computer data files if they are accurate, complete, and confidential. So, papasok dito yung CIA triad mo. Confidence, integrity, and availability. Okay? So, number one, overall objective, your security. Okay? Types of security, errors and fraud found by the companies, dapat ma-identify to if there are any. And of course, control procedure to minimize security error, there should be security protection plan, restrictions, logic access, you have your most famous password, your antivirus software, backup and recovery, and fault-tolerant design. For the objective, okay, continue natin, you do your system review audit procedure. Okay, what else? For the overall security, you do test of control and you identify if there is control weakness so that you know if you should be implementing compensating control. So what should you do to lessen the weakness of this existing control? Okay? And of course, dito mo rin makikita, meron bang mga user control? Is there segregation of duties? So kung wala, dapat isegregate mo yung mga incompatible duties. Next, program development and acquisition. The role of auditor in the system development should be limited to an independent review of system development activities. And of course, the auditor should review the policies, procedures, and the standards and documentation of an entity. Okay? Next, program modification. When program change is submitted for approval, a list of all required updates should be compiled and approved by management and program user. Ito yung sinasabi natin na unless there is a written authentication or authority na pwede mong i-modify ang program or let us say a certain document, hindi dapat pwede mangyari yon. So, dapat pag nakita ni auditor, oops, merong modification na nangyari, hindi naman authorized, audit findings mo yan. And of course, to test for an authorized program, auditor can use source code comparison program. Okay? Another additional techniques for the audit in terms of your computer or program modification, you have reprocessing techniques that also uses verified copy of source code, and you do your parallel simulation, meaning you do a similar process to reprocessing except that the particular auditor writes a program instead of saving a verified copy of the source code. Okay, and you, or the auditor, I should say, will compare the result with the company's result and identify or investigate the differences. And of course, for your computer processing, you should focus on the processing of the transaction files. Paano ba ginagawa? Where does it start? Where does it go? Where does it end? Okay? And nakaka-detect ba yung system mo ng mga erroneous input? Diba? Dapat sana at least kahit paano meron, kumbaga, yung mga maximum minimum values mo or figures. And then of course, does it properly correct input errors? Okay? Let's say meron ba siya magiging reference kung sakasakali. Now, you have options to test your processing control. Number one, processing test data. Number two, concurrent audit techniques and analyzing program logic. So, sa process test data, this is one way to test program. To process a hypothetical series and valid and invalid transactions. You have listing of actual transaction, you test the transaction, the programmer used to test the program, and then a test data generator program which automatically prepares test data based on the specified or based on the program specification. What else? You have your disadvantages of processing test transaction. Ang kailangan lang dito ng auditor mo is ample time. So, dapat meron siyang i-allot na time talaga when he wanted or she wanted to do process test data. And of course, careful process. And of course, kapag gagawin mo ang concurrent audit, the auditor uses this audit to continually monitor the system and collect audit evidence while live data are processed during regular operating hours. So, concurrent yung paggawa mo ng process. So, kahit may nagpa-process real-time, ginagawa mo din siya. Okay? And you use embedded audit module. Alright. So, you normally use 5 concurrent audit techniques when you do concurrent audit techniques. Ayan. Integrated test facility, snapshot technique, system control audit review file or your SCARF, audit hooks, and continuous and intermittent simulation. So what is an integrated test facility? Your integrated test facility placed as a small set of fictitious record in the master file. Okay? And then the auditor will compare processing with the expected result to verify that the system and controls are operating effectively. That's your integrated test facility. How about your snapshot technique? Your snapshot technique will now examine the way the transactions are processed. Paano sila napaprocess, di ba? Doon sa mismong system mo. And selected transactions are marked with special code that triggers that snapshot process. And it focus on correct processing. Si snapshot technique mo, it is focus, the focus is on correct processing. Kung tama ba yung process na dinadaanan. Next, your SCARF, System Control Audit Review File. Anong ginagawa niyan? It will use embedded audit module so that it continuously monitor the transaction activity and collect data on transaction with special audit significance. Next, your audit hooks. Kapag sinabi namang audit hooks, you audit routine that flags suspicious transaction. Okay? Yung audit routine mo, it will flag or it will identify a suspicious transaction. And this approach is also known as real-time notification. Real-time notification, okay? Which will display a message on the auditor's terminal as these questionable transactions occur or those suspicious transactions occur. And one good example of that is your State Farm Life. Anyway, ayan. So, ayan yung audit hooks mo. Next, your CIS or your Continuous and Intermittent Simulation. For your CIS, you embed an audit module in a database management system. The CIS module will examine all the transactions that update the database using criteria similar to your SCARF. So, yung ginagamit mong criteria kay SCARF, yun din yung gagamitin mo kay CIS mo. Okay? So, you have now your analysis of program logic. Let's proceed. For the analysis of program logic, if the auditor suspects, okay, or identifies that a particular application program contains unauthorized code or serious error, then a detailed analysis can still be done necessarily. So, ito yung mga items na possible na magpahaba ng audit mo. Okay? There are softwares that can create automatic flowchart. It can create automated decision table, scan occurrence of variable or characters. It will map an executed code and trace program step. Okay? Ito yung mga software na tutulong kay auditor mo kung sakaling magkaroon ng suspected unauthorized code or serious error. This will help the auditor to further investigate, okay, and analyze on the program logic. Next, punta tayo sa source data. Doon sa objective 5 mo, your auditor use an input control matrix. The matrix will show the control procedure applied to each field of an input record, okay? The internal control that prevent, detect, and correct inaccurate or unauthorized data source. Whatever is needed to understand the control on entry of data source. The authorization, and of course, are there any control that we need to compensate or that the auditor thinks is needed to be compensated. So that's for your data source. In terms of your data files, the concern is your accuracy, integrity, and security of data stored in the machine-readable files. So, in terms of accuracy, correct ba? Diba? Saan ito magbibase? Sa process as well as sa source document. In terms of integrity, can it be modified? Or is there a trustworthiness? Okay, trustworthy ba yung information or file na nakatago or nakastore? And of course, how sure are we? Okay? That the information or files are secured, hindi magagalaw, hindi mananahaw, hindi mawawala, hindi ma-erase. Okay? Next, you have your computer software audit. There are number of computer audit software and generalized audit software. Now, written by specific, especially for auditors. Okay? So, itong mga software na to will help your audit of your CIS. So if you are in a company at kasali ka sa IT, o kaya naman you have a company and you are running using a computer system, huwag mo nang itry na mag-perpetrate ng fraud. Kasi with the use of the computer software today by the auditors, madali na lang makita kung meron kang fraudulent transaction or material misstatements. What is your general audit software? It is a software designed to read, process, and write data with the help of function performing specific audit routines and with self-made macros. So, para siyang in short na ma-manipulate ni auditor. Depende sa gusto ni auditor na feature or function. Okay? You have your computer software audit. The two most popular software are your audit control language and your IDEA. Your audit control language are data interrogation tool used by the auditor to view, to explore, and to analyze data efficiently and cost effectively. Okay? Your ACL will enable auditor to access data in diverse format and various type of storage device. Ibig sabihin, tinatry ni auditor mo. Pwede ko ba tong ma-generate in this way? Pwede ko ba tong ma-access in this way? Or what are the other diverse format na pwede kong ma-generate or makuha tong information na to? Para doon na rin nila itatest yung control ng iyong system. So sabihin nila, oops, this should not happen. Kasi kayang-kaya pala ni employee X na kunin tong information na to with this process. Next, you have your IDEA, Interactive Data Extraction and Analysis. Is a general audit software. It is able to import a wide range of different types of data files. And during the import, an IDEA file and its field statistics are created. So, statistics naman tayo dito sa IDEA. The primary purpose of your computer or your CAS is to assist auditors in reviewing and retrieving information. So, makikita nila dyan, di ba? Kasi mas mapabilis nila yung retrieving of the information. Kasi if not, kailangan pa nilang assistance ni employee, di ba? Assistance ni management. Eh, paano kung ayaw pa ibigay ni management? At least, mag-generate ni auditor. And of course, CAS cannot replace the auditor's judgment or free of the auditor from the face of the audit. You cannot free the auditor overall. Okay? Meaning, kailangan pa rin ng professional judgment ni auditor, kailangan pa rin ng work ni auditor. Hindi ma-erase yung work ni auditor. Kumbaga sa bookkeeping mo, kahit meron ka ng system, di ba? At pag na-journalize mo na yung entry mo, bahala na si system gumawa ng posting or trial balance later on, dito sa CAS, hindi mo magagawa yon. Okay? Meaning, you still need your auditor per se to do the other process. Next, you have your operational audit of an accounting information system. This is a technique and procedure used in operation audit. Ano ulit ang ginagawa mo kay operation audit to check the effectiveness of your company? How effective are you in using your company resources? Okay? The basic difference is that the scope and information system audit is confined with internal control, whereas the scope of your financial audit is limited to system output. Okay? Your operational audit evidence collection is including your review of operating policies and documentation, confirming procedures with management and operating personnel. You do your observation of the operating functions and activities. You examine financial and operating plans and reports. You test the accuracy of the operating activity, and you do testing of your controls. And ideal operational auditor has audit experience and several years as experience as a manager. Okay? So, ideally, mas maganda daw kung ang operational audit mo, may experience din siya as a first-hand manager. Alright? So, that is your audit in a computerized environment. On our next topic, we will now be focusing on your revenue cycle audit, expenditure cycle audit, and conversion cycle audit. As your activity for this topic, I wanted you to list 10 control for each of those transaction cycle. So what should be the control? It's not necessarily arranged. Okay, basta ilista mo. What should be 10 controls na dapat makikita mo kay revenue transaction cycle, kay expenditure cycle, at saka kay conversion cycle. 10 each, okay? So, 10 na control procedure, ulitin ko, 10 control procedure kay revenue cycle, 10 control procedure kay expenditure, tsaka 10 na control procedure kay conversion cycle, okay? So, please do that and submit that to me at the end of the period. Again, happy learning and see you again on our next video and discussion. God bless on your review and activity.